Hello everybody, my name is...
The amount of fresh graduates facing unemployment increases despite the changes in Malaysia's economy since 1996. People are blaming universities as the main source of graduating unemployable graduates. The issue of how universities have to adapt to the growth of Malaysia from time to time so to ensure they can cope with the new scope of work and environment. This may be because of the student lacking competencies preferred in the industry that provides profitability to the organization these fresh grads are working for.
Number one! What I just read!
Employers will generally assume the student to have the entire core competency fulfilled, especially those under the model that the university follows. The difference being would be the student's ability to fluently provide the skills at the time of need. However, employers expect soft skills greatly from students. Most universities are influenced by the models implemented by the Royal Institute of Chartered Surveyors, also known as RICS, and therefore created a system and syllabus based on the RICS competency model. The education system focuses on students to fulfill the mandatory competencies along with some optional competencies. Fresh graduates over the years have unfortunately worse attitude compared to their counterpart. It is questionable if the university could keep their syllabus and subject up to date with today's construction technology, methodology, and practicality.
Number two, what's your objective?
When this research was proposed, there were three objectives we were to follow. First, to identify the competency that are expected from employers. Two, to understand the educational system that provides the competency to the students. Three, to establish a solution to the difference in expectation of both employers and students' competencies through educational curriculum.
Number three, how are we gonna do it?
The whole research will be done with literature to understand the overall situation. Questionnaire survey for the student and interview for employers and lecturers. The main aim of the survey is to understand the students' learning experience within the university. Questionnaire plays a role of demography to understand the students' background and the students' experience within the construction industry. This factor plays a role in their capability to understand the lecturers at a smoother pace than those who are inexperienced in the industry. Section B revolves around the impact and familiarity of competencies in their experience in the university. These responses serve as a responding variables to the issue at hand and aids in providing an insight of their competencies gained from the university for the industry. This section also attempts to understand what competencies are lacking from the university and should be enhanced. Section C is designed to measure the students' confidence level with the competency gained. Method of interviewing was divided into two targets, one for the employers to address the issue of students' performance in their competencies, including their behavior and attitude. Another was for the lecturers to understand their perspective and opinion towards the problem stated by the employers and the student. The interview was also designed to solve the problem of distinction between the university and the industry itself. The conceptual idea of the research framework was shown mandatory and secondary competency as well as the soft competencies affected by a triangular relationship in competencies. The employers will expect the competencies executed by their students as optimally as possible upon graduation or internship, while the students will rely heavily on the university on relaying the competency as well as providing internship opportunity. The lecturers are responsible for the competencies gained from the construction industry itself.
Scope and limitation!
The research was designed specifically for quantity surveying students in Selangor, Malaysia. The research includes opinion from lecturers and employers in the quantity surveying field on the students' competencies. Research chose three private universities in Selangor due to time restraint. Moreover, due to the amount of time given is limited and most of the employer needed a lot of time or have none to aid the research, the amount of response for interview is difficult to attain.
Expected research outcome!
Employers are assumed to be satisfied with overall competencies provided by the universities. Limitation to visualize the construction technology and thus affect their capability to measure flexibly. The main issue could be the students' soft skills. Subjects are based on the competencies laid out by the RICS and BQSM who are responsible in making chartered or licensed quantity surveying. The interaction between students and lecturers are varied following the style of the lecturer's teaching.
What are the research contributing?
The research aimed to reduce the amount of unemployed fresh graduates by matching the competencies provided and expected competencies by creating an educational framework. The research also attempts to merge the academic capability to fit with the construction industry needs.
In conclusion,
the expectation from the employers may not be as high as expected from the norm. They expect basic from the fresh employees and train them based on the competencies they have. The employers are satisfied with the competencies fresh graduates or interns have shown so far, with the exception of a few complaints.